Interested in if you're eligible. I don't want like a 13-year-old in there coming up here for tuition, because the tuition won't be that much next time. Okay, I want everybody to stand up. Okay, we were really confused about what to do tonight.
Like, we couldn't think of anything.
Like, so we need a cue from you guys.
To like start the entire night. Do you guys have anything that we should start the night?
No, we're, we need a phrase, we need a phrase.
Like a catchphrase. Poopsie?
What?
I don't know if that's allowed to be a catchphrase.
Okay, shh, 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 shh. Okay, these guys were yelling something right here. What were you yelling?
I think they were the poopsie crowd.
Poopsie?
Poopsie, I don't really get it.
Who's your daddy?
Who's your daddy?
You want to do who's your daddy just for the fun of it? Just because we can?
Just
let's do it. Let's do it, okay?
You got to go crazy, though.
Okay, ready? One, two, three. Who's your daddy?
Thank you. Give to you this day. If my life, Lord, have your way.
I love that song. I'm not that much of a rock and roller, but man, that song just about says everything I want to say. I don't know about you. Let's do this one more time. Now, before we get too hyped, I just want to say this. Lord, you are absolutely everything to us. Nothing else. We don't need anything else but you. And I love what Chad said last night. He said when he bent down to give the guy pushed it away and he says, no, you've given me everything tonight. He is everything. And so right now, this is the place, and Lord, we want your glory to come down, and we've all gathered in this room to do one thing, and that's worship you. But I want each and every one of you from here, from your heart, from your gut, I want you to sing this like you've never sung it before, okay? I want you to give the Lord shouts of praise and glory tonight. Come on.
Thank you. my side, a very big gato. He's always by my side, a very big gato. By my side, a very big gato. He's always by my side.
I dance in your holy presence, and I sing of your love for me, and I'm lost in your sweet presence. When you come and dance with me, and I dance in your holy presence. sing of your love for me, and I'm lost in your sweet presence. When you come and dance with me, dance away the night.
You're
times I dance in your holy presence. Love your love for me, and I'm lost in your sweet presence. When you come and dance with me, and I dance.
Light of the world, light.
tonight, Lord, and we long for more of you, and all we have to do is stretch our hands to heaven, and you will see us through. You go about us and you're singing over us and you're dancing over us and you're singing the song of freedom. You're singing the song of freedom. Just what if we all go back to our homes and the glory of God comes down and it shakes every bone? What if we all go back and unify? And prepare a place for the Lord to come down and be glorified. With one voice we sing.
Jesus. The Lord says many of you question. Many of you out there question. That when we speak of this generation and we speak of what God has for you, He says many of you question all this. Some of you doubt it. The Lord says that He called every one of you here by divine appointment. And He says to look past the songs and look past the message and look past your youth group and look at the big picture, because it's deeper than what you think it is. Many of you know in your heart that when you go back to your church, when you go back home, many of you believe in your heart that nothing's going to change. But that's where you're wrong, and I believe the Lord is saying that to you now. That is wrong. But right now, in the presence of the King, He is putting you, He's putting the cover of the glory on you. And right now, I believe He's actually calling many of you out there into the ministry, and He's calling many of you out there closer to Him, and He's saying, put away the things that are distracting, and He's saying, I want you for myself. Because when you do that, that's your link, and then the questions are no more. There's no more questions then as to what you can do for the kingdom of God. But this generation's anointing is the glory of the Lord. It's nothing more. It's the glory. It's the glory of the Lord. And when you have that, you can do anything. So right now, what I want you to do is, I don't care how you express it, but many of you are still in the third day. You haven't felt like you've touched the Lord. Now's your chance. Get past the songs. Look at the bigger picture. This is the bigger picture. That God's glory wants to come on you so that you can go back and do mighty, mighty things in your communities and in your churches. And He's doing that as a result of your worship to Him. So right now, just lift up your voice and praise Him and honor Him and let the Lord move in this service. We don't need any more songs. This is what we came to do right now. And this is what the Lord wants to do to you right now in Jesus' name. Come on, pour it out. Pour it out. No more doubt, no more fear. This is what we came to do. Call out on His name. Call out on His name. Call out on His name. Let the cry of this generation be heard in the land. Let the mouths of babes be full of praise to the Lord.
Come on, just you, no singers, come on.
Beyond our galaxy, you are home. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You may begin to make your way back to your seat tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Worship team, if you'll stay with me for a few moments. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you're so awesome. You're so awesome in this place. You turn the lights on for me, please, all over the building. Praise the Lord. Where is Branson, Missouri at? You guys, run up here real quick. Come up here real quick. This is one unique group of teenagers. Where's the teacher at? Where's that teacher at? Where's your leader? Come here, teach. These guys, you guys aren't from the same church, are you? Come up here, teach. What's your name again?
Margie.
This is... Margie's been bringing teenagers from Branson for 4 years straight now, right? She is a Spanish teacher, is that right?
Si.
I guess that means yes. How many of y'all have her for Spanish? How many of y'all have had her for Spanish?
Yeah.
Okay, several of you. And every year, she always brings teenagers, not from necessarily her church, but from several different churches. Okay, do I have any Presbyterians here? Now come here for a minute. Come here, sit. Come here. Now wait a minute. You can't be Presbyterian, sis. You're Presbyterian?
Yeah.
I didn't know they did that kind of stuff in the Presbyterian church.
I don't.
You girls aren't acting like Presbyterians.
I'm sorry.
She says, I'm sorry. You girls love Jesus, don't you?
Some.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. I feel sorry for your church. You're going to have some confused people when you go home. Let's see now. Do we have any Baptists in this group? Where are my Baptists at? Y'all run up here. Our Baptists. Don't you guys think this is wonderful? You guys are Baptists? You guys are about the most exciting Baptists I've ever seen in my life. You guys are radical, man. Do you normally act like this at church?
No.
Is this your first time here?
Third
time. Your first time? Have you enjoyed yourself?
Yeah.
Awesome, man. Awesome. Y'all give it up for our Baptist friends up here. What other churches do we have represented up here? Huh? Non-denominational. How many of you are non-denominational? Just step up here on the steps. Really? Now, see, I'm just amazed at this. This blows my mind that a Spanish teacher and some other leaders, look at all these non-denominational, my lands. They just, she's got problems over there. Actually, I don't think she has a problem in the world.
Yeah. The Lord is coming for one church.
I'm sorry?
The Lord is coming for one church.
The Lord's coming for one church. Amen. Awesome. Wow. Now, do we have any Assembly of God in this bunch at all? We have a couple Assembly of God. How about Church of God? Do we have any Church of God among you? No. Methodists. How many of you Methodists? I got some other Methodists in the house. Come on now. Well, that's awesome, guys. Listen, I am so excited about you being here. I'm so excited. Let me tell you something. Here's what I'm excited about. It's not just a church, but I understand. Do all of you go to the same school or do you go to different schools? Two main different schools. You know what? I think it's good. Well, you know, I'm so excited about it. You guys are going to be able to go back to your school. You're not going to say it's a church thing. It's a God thing. You know what I'm saying? It's a God thing. And I believe the Lord, listen, I believe the Lord is going to fulfill prophecy that one of you was telling me today, that God is going to mightily move at Branson, Missouri. I believe that. So everybody extend your hands this way right now. Extend your hands this way. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, not only at Branson, but all over America. But Lord, right now we pray for Branson, Missouri.
Lord, we pray that the prophecy that you have spoken over this city would come to pass, Lord, that the glory of the Lord would fall on this city. Let it fall on these schools, Lord, on these churches. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the heavens be open. Let your glory be declared in Jesus' name. And everybody said,
amen.
Y'all give it up for Branson tonight, would you? Awesome, guys. I'm so proud of you. Give it up for my worship team tonight. Haven't they done an awesome, awesome. And I'll probably introduce them to you tomorrow night. Those of you on the worship team can only imagine, they've been doing this for 2 weeks now. We're talking hours upon hours upon hours of playing. And they just always do it with such joy. It's such an honor for them. And I just love them, and I'll be honoring them tomorrow night. But I want to move on with the service tonight.